I tried doing something nice the other day. I tried holding a door open for a black man, but he was a gentleman. So he was like, no, you go. And I was like, no, you go. And he was like, no, you go. And finally, I had to be like, look, I'm just trying to make up for the Starbucks thing. And he was like, I don't drink coffee. Like, yeah, I think that's why they got kicked out. I'm pretty sure. I don't know what it's like to be a black man in this country, but I do think we focus on a lot of the negative stuff. I don't think we ever focus on the positive things about being a black man. Like, my ex-boyfriend used to be able to fall asleep on the train for hours, and he never got robbed. No one ever tells that story. As a black man, you can fall asleep anywhere and not get robbed. You might get arrested, but you're gonna have all your shit. I think it's possible to say racist things and not actually be racist. Like, anytime somebody cuts me off in a car, I always just scream out whatever race they are. And I thought about it, I was like, why do you do that? And I was like, oh, it's because I know nothing else about this person and I want to hurt them the quickest way I can. So it's my way of saying, I just got to get to know you better to offend you. You can't just yell out at every car that cuts you off like, hey, I'm glad you got molested as a child. And hope it hits. That's a pretty big gamble. Imagine the guy that's upset and he's like, how'd you know I was molested as a child? Like, I've just been saying that to the last 200 cars that cut me off. I'm just glad you had a shitty childhood. I do think black people and white people, eventually we're gonna have to come together, you know? If we have any hopes in overpowering the Puerto Ricans, we... gonna have to work towards a greater good. I don't mean that offensively either. I was Puerto Rican in high school, so. We all were. It was the Bronx. I'm a native New Yorker. I was born and raised in the Bronx, and I still live there. It's like me and one other white family left on my block. Every day I just go up to their house. I'm like, you're not moving, right? I don't want to be here by myself. Most of my friends, when they got money, they left the Bronx. Me and my family, we never had any money. So my mother's like, we're just going to wait for white to come back around. I have this new neighbor, he's Nicaraguan. He was actually like, this is a nice part of the Bronx. And I was like, well, it's not going to stay that way if your friends and family keep moving in. Fine. Put a kibosh on that. Most of my neighbors are Hispanic. They're like constantly blasting Spanish music. I wake up to Spanish music. I go to sleep to Spanish music. It's to the point now I don't even dream in English anymore. All my dreams have subtitles, which sucks because I don't wear my glasses to bed. I'm not saying all Hispanics are loud, but a lot of loud people are Hispanic. We have a stalker in my neighborhood. Everyone's freaked out about it except for me, because I was like, I actually wouldn't mind a stalker. I lose a lot of stuff. It would be helpful if I could go outside to some guy sitting in a car and be like, hey, when we were at the ATM machine, did you see what I did with my debit card? Not a lot of cannibals in the Bronx. That's not a Bronx crime. Probably because nobody wants to carry a body up 5 flights of stairs. You figure by the time you find some guy that looks delicious, drag him to the train, transfer 3 times. By the time you get home, you're like, I'm fucking exhausted. I think I'm just gonna get a burrito. If I was a cannibal, I would never like kill some guy and then bring him back to my house. I would just like order a pizza and then kill that guy. Well, I have takeout when you can have delivery. I know, I think the hardest part about getting away with murder is not being able to brag about it to your friends. Right? You're at a party, your friend's going on about his promotion, and you're like, I'm doing stuff too.